All right, Harry Lloyd and I are old friends because you remember WGN America series Manhattan, which was so wonderful, which filmed in the Southwest.
That was the best. I was so mad when I wish there was a third year of that. That was such
too.
A good show.
Me too.
But more importantly for Harry, so he loved the role, but what about the dog?
The dog was my main takeaway from the series. I rescued a tiny little Chihuahua Pomeranian from a Santa Fe dog shelter who about 3.5 years ago, who now lives with me and my wife.
And travels the world with you.
She travels everywhere. She's not here today. But she would normally like to come along for the ride.
And is it hard to have a dog live in London and travel in and out of England?
It would be if she wasn't such a little star. She's just very calm and she just likes people and she's no trouble. She's wonderful.
Yeah. All right, the other credits we, of course, should mention. Khaleesi's brother on Game of Thrones, Stephen Hawking's BFF and The Theory of Everything. So many good things, including the show Counterpart, a huge billboard on Sunset as I was driving in this morning. You said you guys had a cast dinner last night.
We did, yeah. We're all in town for the premiere tomorrow night.
You're all actors. Does everyone just order salad, or does anyone actually tuck in and like?
Actually, you know what was great last night is that they ordered everything, and so they just brought food out, and no one could complain and talk about their vegan diet.
Oh, it
was
thank all God. Yeah. That's
I'm glad you bring this up, though. When you're at other, read-throughs or whatever, is everybody citing their own weird? I'm a pescatarian. I'm vegan. I'm gluten-free.
I've seen it happen.
Right.
This cast is very down-to-earth and predominantly European. So actually, there's less of that.
All right. Goodness. All right. Before we get more into the show, I do have to ask the key question. Game of Thrones final season. Are you just so fascinated by it?
I am. I am. And I'm in the dark as anyone else now.
Right.
Sadly departing early on in that season, in the first season. Now I'm watching like everyone else.
Why do you think this show has struck a chord with people in a way that, frankly, few shows do?
I don't know. I think it's partly goes hand in hand with the rise of television. That this before would have been maybe some huge blockbuster movie or trilogy. And the fact that you can take that many hours over it and really get involved at that high level of budget. I was amazed, even in the first season, that there is such detail in the script and then such scale in the production. And that marriage I hadn't seen before on TV.
See, we have here neither detail nor scale.
Nor.
It's not.
That's the title of Sam's upcoming book, The Rise of Television.
There we go. All right, to Counterpart. Tell us about it.
Counterpart is set today, and it's a kind of spy-fi thriller in that it's based on this situation where in the late Cold War in Berlin, the world got copied. So there are two identical realities. And as they become more and more aware of them through the single crossing in Berlin, there is this covert war now going on. And into season two now, there are people on one side pretending to be on the other side. And there's a lot of espionage and double dealings. And it's very exciting.
The idea of the world being copied, or as Mark Kritsky says, Thursdays. J.K. Simmons, we know, of course, because of such good work. And he has this double role and everything.
Yeah.
Is it confusing? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Secretly, very confusing. Mm. Yeah, no, you have to keep your wits about you, for sure. Mainly for him, who does most of the double acting, in especially the first season. But there's something, I think people were worried when we were first making it, that are people going to know which one we're looking at? And after the first 2 weeks, I think they were looking at monitors, and they said, before he opens his mouth, you can just tell. There's something about the posture that he has for that character. Mm. There are just these tiny little differences. And it's that, I think, is one of the most exciting things about watching it.
We will tell you, Counterpart Season 2 will premiere Sunday, December 9th on Starz. Harry, good to see you this morning.
You too. Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
Thanks very much
for being here.